So this is this vehicle is V3D's fantastic upper solo, I believe that's called in real life. That's a fantastic model. I really do like this model, it has to be said. But yeah. Right. Let's get this started. This can be a bit of a pain sometimes to get started. No, oh, it's going to start first line for me. Excellent. Sometimes there's a habit of doing that when it glitches up. So yeah, this is fantastic, as I said, a superb 3D, V3D's brand new bus that's been what he's brought out. He has got a double decker on its way as well, I do believe. I do have a copy of that, that will be in a YouTube video very, very shortly. So yeah, you will get to see that, don't worry. You will miss out on that content. Oh, I am. Yeah. Oh, okay. I was a little bit confused, I have to say. What? I never hit any car. What are you on about? I don't recall hitting any car. I'm not gonna lie, this bus actually sounds like it's farming. I ain't gonna sugarcoat that one. It actually sounds like it's farming. Sounds like a cat stuck in the bus. Either that's a dog. One of the two, but. Horn sound like now because I can't play the. Oh jeez! My horn's louder than the bus. So, if you do want the branding patch for this bus, then you need to go on to the Dig Eye Bus website and download the branded patch that is available on the website Dig Eye Bus and you'll find the website and you can download the branded patch because it does come with a branded patch so you can have Opa, or whatever the bus is called, the Opa Solo, comes with the branded patch, so you don't have to look at the Dig Eye Bus. So it's got an official branded patch version as well, what you're able to download. Fortunately, as you know, we added the time to install the branded patch. I did have it, I got it the first day, but when I verified my game file, then took it out because it's a paper DLC. So you removed the branding patch. If you are putting branding patches in, if you put anything into your thing. I've lost my train of thought. If you're putting anything into OMSI, what isn't been purchased on Steam, that will not fix your files. If say that you put in like something off the Bella films, buses of the West Country, that will not do anything to that file. So it won't even touch the file because it only touches Steam files or things that it can pull from the Steam server. So if you messed up your files for, say, buses in the West Country, you'll have to manually fix them yourself. Because the game, Steam will not verify the game files because it's not theirs. People think that it fixes it, but it actually doesn't. It doesn't even touch the files because it can't pull it from the Steam servers. So it's only official DLC contents in the game that will fix, that will replace. So if you have a branded patch, say, for a freeware bus, and then you go to verify your game file, that random patch will still be there. Just for that one specific boss. I found this out by accident the other day when I was messing around with the MMC 200s when I put a random patch in to the steering wheel. Validate my game files, and then I realised that I hadn't even touched the MMC 200s steering wheel patch. A bit jumpy. I've literally got my foot to the floor, so when this decides to stop freezing, I wondered why it kept going freezing all of a sudden. Yeah, it's because being a dingbat, accidentally forgot to turn down all the benches. Now that was interesting. Now, I don't mind this bus. I think it's absolutely fantastic. I do like V3D stuff. The only thing I don't like about this bus, right, is that the wheels are in front of the driver. That's the only thing I've got with this bus. There is no front end swing on this bus. If you look in a second, yeah, as you can see, there is no front end room for swing. That's the only thing that I find wrong with this bus. Everything else, absolutely perfect. I just don't like it how the wheels are in front. So if I'm going around a tight corner, then it's going to be pretty difficult to get around that tight corner with a bus that's got the wheels here in front of the driver. Because I have to then judge with the wheel ratio.